Hello, hello, hello. Sorry that took so long. I was getting my drink and had a minor spill in the kitchen, so. But here I am. Hello, both of you. Hello. This is for tomorrow. So, just got done working a closing shift, but I was determined to get some done tonight. Because, gosh darn it, I have to. How's everyone doing? You the one that keeps saying sleep when you're dead? So now we're learning you're all talk. But that's good. A lurk is always good. Whatever works for you. Sleeping or painting. Plate of pizza rolls. Yeah, there's always some crap in real life. But welcome back. It's not shaping up to your third. I just got on. I could finish real quick, just for you, just so you can get some sleep. How you doing, pizza rolls? Is there SR? What do you mean? Oh, no, I don't have song requests set up because I was kind of wondering if people even knew the songs that Pretzel plays, because I don't. Have you guys heard those songs before? I just have it set up to their ambient channel right now. Their ambient and chill sounds, songs sound pretty cool. But yeah, this is only the second time I've used it, so I'm not real familiar with how it works, other than just turn it on. I know there's an option to do song requests, but I didn't do it, because it takes bits, and the minimum is 100 bits just to request a song, so I thought that was kind of expensive. What do you guys think? Is that expensive? There's a good gaming one, no lyrics. Yeah, I don't want lyrics. But is it a gaming channel with Pretzel, or is it more gaming music, you mean? You know what? I think they have a gaming channel. Maybe you're talking Pretzel. Let me look real quick. rock, chiptune, chills, happy, upbeat, epic, mixed, synthwave, ambient, hype, pop, EDM, hip-hop. So that's their channels. Pizarro, if you happen to know the link of what it is that you were talking about, put it in there. Charcoal's gonna, or Gerbil, I usually call you Gerbil. Gerbil's going to watch and cut pieces of foil and cellophane. Okay. Sounds like a plan. On the couch. No messes on the couch allowed unless you plan on doing it. Thank you. Lost a piece of where? In the couch? Magically flew. It escaped your clutches.
I was walking one day when I happened upon an old man. He was sitting on a bench, staring into the distance as if it were endless. I smiled politely as I passed, but his voice rasped behind me. A voice like his hands, wrinkled and often used, but still sharp with wisdom and concern. It was a question he posed to me. "How do I know that you exist?" he asked. I stood a dozen silent paces from him, but I didn't return to his bench. After a moment of thought, I spoke. "You don't any more than I know that you do." His lips twitched in what may have been a smile, but I couldn't really tell.
Foil dust. You're making little pixies. Metallic pixies. Thank you. Every time Pretzel says what song's playing, I always think someone said something. It's distracting me. Gam, or should I just say Gam? How you doing? You are lurking. That's cool, man. I have lots of lurkers. Gam? Okay. Will do. No, you didn't mention that, but it sounds like you learned that the hard way. Do not sneeze. Kliska 4. Kliska? Kliska? I like Kliska. How do you say that? Can't go back to sleep. Yeah, why sleep? If your body's saying wake up. Crumpet toast. Fanny pack and sun visor. What are you talking about? Do you want this character to have a fanny pack and sun visor? Every good drawing needs one, yeah. Show feet. I always show feet when I draw. Well, not always, but you know. You have to do feet. You have to do feet and hands. Barf bag. Wow, getting a lot of folks that haven't been here in a little while. Glad to see everyone back. I liked fanny packs. It's too bad they're not in vogue anymore, but I still have one. I used it the other day at the street fair. Well, actually, more truthfully, my wife used it the other day. But it comes in handy. Fanny packs are super handy. they're currently in. Are they back? Fanny packs are back. Yep, it's a Goyle. It's going to rake in the viewers. I don't know. I don't know if I can make it sexy enough. Yeah, sort of a skirt thing going on. I'm going to show the midriff. So I don't know if we'll get some sex appeal or not, but I'll try. I'll try. She farting. Yeah, can't you tell? Look at that thing blow. Nah, I can't draw cheesecake very well at all, to be honest. So there's other artists that can blow me away. And yeah, I'm not really here to do cheesecake. Although I'd like to draw a nice picture that's a woman character. So that's what I'm working on. Yeah, I don't know where it comes from, but if you draw a woman that's in a sexual position, somehow the slang of it is cheesecake. You're drawing cheesecake. I have no idea where the phrase came from, and it's probably very old since I'm very old. Let's see. Do I watch other creative streams? Yeah, I watch quite a few, really. I don't try to watch too many, to be honest, because it would be so easy to get distracted and never stream again. So I try to take it easy. Plus, my time's been so gobbled up lately. I don't have time to do too much. It could be, but then blow is slang already, so cheesecake could be slang for other slang. Two-tiered slang, just to throw people off. So I said G-Gam, but is it G-Gaming? Right, like gaming? Am I just overthinking it? I don't know, that might be drawing men or something. In fact, cheesecake may have originated to be sexualized men in somehow, some way. It is supposed to be gaming or gammon, but name is Gigi. Oh, your real name is Gigi? Oh, that makes it easier. Pretzels going and Nightbot. There's so much spam. I can't see what you guys are typing. What do you guys think of the pretzel music? is it worth it, or do you like the tabletop audio, or do you like what's the other thing I had? Kevin MacLeod or whatever his name was. I know, huh? All the pie, like lemon meringue. I want to draw lemon meringue. Love lemon meringue. I used to love just good old-fashioned apple pie a la mode and cherry pie, but I think nowadays lemon meringue is kind of my favorite. Yeah, we pie bros. Hardware is Mac. My drawing pad is a Wacom Intuos 3. My software is Clip Studio Paint. We're all Pi Bros here. That should mean something, Pi Bro. That should be slang for something. I love Clip Studio Paint for the reasons, for what I do, I love it more than Photoshop. So I like the pencils better in Clip Studio Paint. I like the line control better in Clip Studio Paint. I think Photoshop's still a better painter, but I just like using Clip Studio Paint. And you've all seen me ink the lines, right? If I start inking a line, you know, I mean, look how crisp those lines are. They have a good tapered edge. You cannot get lines like that in Photoshop. So that's why I like using Clip Studio Paint for inking especially. Missing a toe. How am I going to fit in a toe? I need 5 damn toes. Damn it. Yeah, I mean, Photoshop, I think, blows away Clip Studio Paint in just the raw painting. It's hard to beat Photoshop because there's so many things you can do and the layers are just fantastic. But you can do most of that. You can do most of that in Clip Studio Paint, and you can do most of that in any good art program. You know, it really doesn't matter. The program doesn't matter that much. But Clip Studio Paint has the best inking tools, so that's why I use it more than anything else. Yeah, I honestly wouldn't worry too much about the application, but it's always nice to be using an application that you enjoy drawing with. Like I was looking at all of them, trying to decide which one I want to focus on, because I knew I didn't want to learn them all. That takes too much time. And was it Sketch Pro maybe? Oh, there's a bug in here. I gotta kill it. Sketch Pro, the one by, was it Autodesk? I was really thinking of using that one too. But at the time, none of the other ones could draw out the resolution that I needed either. Alright, hold on. I gotta kill a bug. I'll be right back. I don't know where it went. San Diego's infested. Oh, there he is. Spider. I thought it was him. But San Diego's infested with these bugs. They look like mosquitoes, but they're not mosquitoes. So they don't suck blood. They don't bother you. But they're just kind of creepy. And we have tons and tons and tons of them. Alright. Are you drawing for a game or anything, or just fun? Good. Good to hear you guys are okay with me killing a bug. I was actually like, oh crap, what if they're bug lovers? What if they're like, what organization would be like PETA, right? But for bugs instead of pets, or not pets, but instead of animals and dogs and stuff. You know, I'm gonna have to make her shoe bigger, because see? That's right. That's right. I should have captured it for your lizard. Next time. There was a question I have to answer. So I got to, I have a plan, and I have multiple plans. So here's what it is. All of these characters that I'm drawing, all the D&D characters that I've been drawing, the plan is to make some art cards that are going to be 5x7. It'll have the stats on the back and the picture on the front. A little bit of design stuff. I have to do some graphic design, that kind of stuff. And it's going to be a playing aid for dungeon masters. So they can say, yep, you're playing along. Random encounter, you see a priestess. Bam, here's your priestess, right? Or it could be the ogre, or, you know, any of the other ones that I've been drawing. In fact, you know, this is... I'll pop up the list of what I've made so far. Okay, so Beholder, Bronze Dragon, Deep Gnome, Dryad, Gold Dragon, Halfling, Imhotep, a Lich, Nafeshni, a Priestess, a Roving Mauler, Sabertooth Tiger, Spirit Naga, Violet Fungus, Werewolf, Will-O-Wisp, and a Zombie. So those are the ones I've done so far. So they're going to be part of this card deck that you can get for Bugs Lives Matter. Thank you. That Dungeon Masters can use. On top of that, I can do commissions. On top of that, I'm going to be working with a game developer We verbally said we're going to do it. We'll have to see if he gets around to it or not, but I think it's just a matter of time. But I will be working with a game developer to do his game art for this solo. It's going to be a fantasy. It's going to be like Dungeons & Dragons, but it doesn't use the same exact game mechanics. But it's going to be very similar. And then might even use some of these monsters that I've been drawing for that game as well. But it's going to be a solo game where you can actually play, and the game is dictated by the events that happen. And each time you play the game, it's going to turn out differently, because sometimes, you know, it's based on a die roll. You know, you can make it, if you can choose to go down path A, roll the dice, so this is what happens down path A, connect the tile, go on the next, you know, next part of the adventure. So the game mechanic sounds freaking awesome, so I'm looking forward to doing art for that guy. So, long answer, yes, I do it for fun. Yes, I'm trying to get better so that I can retire as an artist and do this for the rest of my days. Yes, I'm doing it with a plan to do some D&D stuff. And yes, I'm doing it with a plan to do some game art as well. It sounds good. The game sounds really good. He's on... I'm not sure what, but there's a forum for other game developers that do tabletop games and stuff, and he's been, you know, kind of talking to folks there, and people are excited about it and volunteering to be alpha testers and the whole bit. So I don't know, it sounds pretty cool. I'm excited about it. I've been wanting to do game art, you know, ever since I started. So when he asked me if I wanted to do his game art, I'm like, well, yeah. Yeah, so keep, you know, if you're not in Discord, stay in Discord, join my Discord. I'm going to create a channel. It's going to be a text channel. It's going to be Chaos Fantasy Quest. So this is just our working name. Create channel. Okay, so on Discord there is Chaos Fantasy Quest, and that's going to be updates about the game. Hey, Sketchbook. Yep. You've been here for a while. Sorry, I'm a little slow on the uptake. Cool. Yep, so Chaos Fantasy Quest. I'll give you guys updates. I'm supposed to meet with the guy this week. I was supposed to, but we were both too busy. But next week we'll get some stuff down. Yeah. Hello, Gigi. There you are. Yeah, let him know. People are excited on Twitch too. So I'm going to be drawing the game stuff on Twitch. So you'll get first look at a lot of stuff regarding the game. But he's been explaining his game mechanics, and I'll be honest, it sounds so fun. I can't wait to play it. Cannot wait to play it. Doing the art will be fantastic, but I want to play the damn game. You know, that channel with Matlock, Golden Girls, and Donahue could take off. Could be the next big thing, I'm telling you. She has some very manly toes. One, two, three, four. Just got endless toes. I'll come back to the toes. I know, right? I mean, I knew when the show was on that it was him, but he looks so different. And he acts so hick in Matlock, right? Yeah, it's pretty amazing. He had that whole career comeback. There was a couple shows. The other show he had was like, I don't know what it was called, but he was trying to build a spacecraft using cheap old tools. Yeah, how did you not know, really? Yeah, of course he was a hick in both, but he seemed Mayberry? He seemed like just a normal guy to me. But yet in Matlock, he just seemed totally hick to me. What was the show where he was trying to build a capsule and go to the moon? With like junkyard material stuff. It was only on, I think, for one season. And I think it was before Matlock. Well, then he had a lot of Southern charm in Matlock. Where's Mayberry? Is that like Kentucky? West Virginia? Where is Mayberry supposed to be? Arkansas? Thank you. fifth list of TV shows and movies. Yeah, but this does all his movies. He was on Dawson's Creek? Family Law? We know about Matlock. Salvage One. That's what it was called. Salvage One. Yep, it was only on for one season. 17 episodes. All you have to do is add dangerous glass glitter to this piece and it should be done. Yeah, be careful. Oh, sorry about the yawn. Time for a power drink. Yeah, it's a good idea. If it's that small, right? You don't want the breeze blowing it, although that might not happen too much, but yeah. Good to be safe. Yeah, I think the varnish will hold it pretty well, to be honest. I think. Auto save already. Thank you. Yeah, I know, she's pretty buff, huh? That's alright. So, Tuatha, who requested the priestess, I said, give me some feedback. She goes, make it a druid sorceress. What else did she say? Druid sorceress priestess. I'm like, okay. Those are all completely different looks for me. So we'll see what I do. So why wouldn't your teacher allow you? Don't you kind of get to pick your own subject matter as long as you fit the parameters of what the assignment is? That's what my, you know, instructors always used to let me do. I could pick the subject matter, but I had to use their parameters. Yeah, you know, I'm more comfortable with erasing than ever before. But part of the reason why I draw in so much layers is so that I don't erase. As much as I want to be the kind of artist that never really needs to erase, I think as you're developing, you just have to, you know? Because you got to make decisions and say, it's working or it's not working. And you got to do it relatively quickly. And erasing is the best way to do it. I think for me, erasing became more comfortable because when I erase and redraw it, most of the time I like it better. So it becomes, I don't know. I just kind of trust it. I trust that when I'm erasing, it's okay. very lopsided. Yeah, just paint over it. Working on some sketches right now. Small reference ones. Cool. I hope so. She's looking very elfish and not even half elf, but who cares? But yeah, she's got a really high forehead. So she's looking like whatever you guys say. And she's really a tiny head. It's funny how when I do the gesture, it looked okay, but when I draw the details, it's like, that's a really tiny head. That's a little better. I don't know. I didn't want to ask for too many details because that gets too much like a commission. And I charge more for commissions. But I just asked for just slightly input. Like right now, to me, she doesn't look like a druid at all. So I'll have to add some elements that make her more druid-like. She looks more like a sorceress. Maybe a princess, or not, priestess. I'm sure to change the clothes a lot. Change the hair. I don't like the big forehead. Although, I would like it on a different character. Yeah, maybe some vines. I like the idea of an animal friend. A crow or something getting ready to land on her shoulder. Yeah, I think she'll have some supporting pets. Thank you. Damn these artists that, you know, start drawing at 2 a.m. in the morning. What the hell are they thinking of? 2 a.m. for me, anyway. So if we fix your jaw, bug hunter. I got it. So I was gonna say, if I fix your jaw, your mouth is a little crooked. If I fix your jaw and her mouth, then maybe she'll be okay. Yeah, you can't tell right now, she's gonna have a staff. So it's her hand's gonna be roughly here. Fingers up gonna be like that, roughly. Hand here, thumb here. Forearm's gonna be here, something like that. And the staff is gonna be coming straight down there. So yeah, I can make it definitely a gnarled wood type thing. Wood staff. Do some kind of lighting effect. No, it's all good. I've got it all. In fact, I would cut and paste it to a text file because they're good ideas. Gives me food for thought. This looks like a collar. I think I need to get some reference. sketchy. Well, I'm thinking about it. So if I soften her job, yeah, I hope so. Or she's got a big ego. I look at her and I think maybe level 7. Around 7. Gerbo, art is patience. Did you sneeze? About you, Gerbil, but I struggle with a lot of my pieces, but I've learned to trust my instincts because I know that I can get a piece looking, you know, okay by the time I'm done with it, as long as I make sure I do my best. So you might be at that stage where you're struggling with the piece and maybe you don't think it looks that good, but if you like the concept and you enjoy the work, you know, just keep plugging away. Enjoy your lurk. Time's flying. I might be done in 15 minutes anyway. I wish I didn't have to do work. I would draw all the time. Fix everything later. Everything that's broken, I'll fix later. All right. Bacon. Oh, Night Night. Now I understand. 10 minutes later. Not Nini, Night Night. Is it Night Night? Got it. I'm very slow in the uptake. I don't really like copping out and not drawing the hand. The hand would not be that far down to the knee. Not even close. That forearm is way too long. So let's get rid of that. Thank you. Alright, you can burn your bunny. That's something else that sounds like it should be slang for, what could it mean? I have to go burn my bunny. Vorpal bunnies. I remember Vorpal bunnies. Monster or character. So some of the things can be just like the halfling. So this is just a priestess. So it's a class. I'll draw the classes as well. I'll draw a ranger, you know, a more typical druid, that kind of stuff. So this would be the first class. I'm looking at other stuff that I've done. Yeah, most everything would be a monster except for the halfling, which is more of a race, not a class even. But it was a halfling fighter, so I could say it's a fighter. Oh, the Vorpal Bunny. It would be a monster. Any bunny that can jump up and bite off my head on a natural 20 is definitely a monster. I gotta really learn to draw mouths better. I'm having a hard time. They don't look natural at all. So many things I gotta draw better. Folds, you know, clothing, metal, freaking everything. Actually, her stance is pretty close to this guy's stance in a way. At least the arm. Oh well. You know, I don't know about the Vorpal Bunny. If it's not on the monster list, it's not part of the OGL, so the open game license. But it could be that they're not even treating Vorpal Bunnies as, you know, canon. So if they're not treating it as a real monster, it's probably up for grabs. But I can always draw it. Another idea for background. Light gray and dark gray storm clouds in the sky, with vines up the lower leg and along the ground. Duality of the nature. Yep, crow companion. It'd be cool if her staff had a crow as the head of the staff with the wings out. Like the headpiece that Tonto had in the last Lone Ranger. I think he had crow's feathers out like that, right? Alright. It is 4 a.m. I think I'm going to call it. Right? Crow's head for the staff. Alright, so I got a little further. Do you guys have a... Hey, Ben. Hey, you snuck in there. How you doing? You caught me right on the tail end. I was just getting ready to ask you guys if you have any preference for a raid or anything. Tough when it's this late. This is but Europe should be waking up. Let's see. Let's surprise this Kishira. I know nothing about her. I just started following her the other night. Sort of manga style stuff, I guess. Very delicate drawings. Let's see. Trying to open her up another window. Because the two window raid seems to work the best. Alright, come on, let's try it. Has a hard time. There we go. What? What's going on? Alright. Whew! I don't even know if she interacts very much, to be honest. But you don't have to stay too long. Whew. have a rating in 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Good night, everyone. Party of four? I thought I had a party of eight.